Right, so we're going to have a look at part two here, which is strings and integers. Okay, so it's just a little video showing the differences between the two. So in our previous video, we looked at printing strings, and strings are encased in these speech marks. Okay, and essentially they will print out exactly what is inside the speech marks. Okay, so anything inside a speech mark is a string. Okay, so for example, I've got some numbers in here in speech marks, run the code, it should print out as is. Okay, now also, here we go, we have another type of data in Python, and these are called integers. And integers are numbers, but numbers that you can do a calculation with. Okay, so if I type in what I typed in above there, but without speech marks this time. Okay, so we'll run the program and see what happens. Okay, so it prints out exactly the same. Okay, but what's the difference between these two? They've printed out the same, but the computer sees them as two different things. And the computer sees this one as a string because it's the speech marks, and this one as an integer because it doesn't have speech marks. Okay, but that's kind of not where the story ends, because an integer is there to do calculations with, and that's the key point of what an integer is. It's a number that you can do a calculation with. You could have a number that is a string. Okay, you could also have the same number that's an integer. But this one's different. This one's you can do calculations with. So let's just do a simple one here. Let's go for one. Should we do plus one? We'll keep it really simple. And we do exactly the same up here, but this time in as a string. Okay. So one plus one and then one plus one. So both exactly the same, but you should see a difference this time. If you remember previously, we both had the two numbers in there. That was a string, that was an integer, and they came out the same. This time we should see a difference. So here we've got the string version, okay, 1 plus 1. It's just printed exactly what's in there. Now here, without the speech marks, it's actually run the calculation for us and given us the answer. Okay, so although they look the same, apart from the speech marks, they're doing two different things. Okay, and it's really important just to kind of get your head around the fact that there's these two ways of using or entering data into Python. One is string entry, okay, with speech marks, and it will print out exactly what is inside the speech marks, and the second is integer entry, where we use numbers to do calculations. So have a little play with some wild calculations, okay, see what you can come up with. There'll be all kinds of crazy things, and Python will very happily do all the calculations for you. Here's a little challenge for you. Can you get a string and an integer on the same line? Okay, little hint for you. Use commas to split things up inside a print statement.